So I'm going to share with the Olam three interesting shaylos that have been asked very, very quite often actually lately. And I've discussed this with Poiskim, and it's something relatively new. And since this goes to Baruch Hashem hundreds and really over 1,000 people, maybe we could get a little more clarity. Number one, we need a good plumber. And number one, we need people that understand halacha. So I'm going to schmooze this out because a few people asked me the following question. Number one, there's a new system, a boiler system, where the actual fire is not underneath the boiler. And as a plumber tried to describe to me, he felt that this way on Shabbos, one is allowed to use hot water. What's the shaila of using hot water? The old shaila was, is that when a person uses a tap, right, Friday night, you want to help your wife wash the dishes, and the water's cold. So you want to use hot water. Now, what's the concern? When you use the hot water, it actively causes cold water to go into the boiler and heat up the water. And that's called at least a gram bio, which is gram havar. You're causing water to be heated up and to boiled up. And therefore, that could be a shaila of bishul on Shabbos. So there was many, many years ago, I saw actually in the Jewish press, he used to have a thing of Shlomo Klass, and I think that was his name, and he used to say that it's okay, I think, for even quarter of Salavachik. Why? Because it's considered a grama. But Pashup Shat usually will machmir, because not necessarily that's considered a grama. And even if it is, it could be what's called a davash, a grama, that where there's nichale, that means you're getting a benefit. That's one shayla. But today, so a plumber wants to tell me that this is a little bit better because not necessarily is water going to go in. And this is something that I'm trying to clarify. Is it true that there's a system that of water that when you use the hot water and you didn't turn anything off, that there's no cold water that's going to be reheated? Question number one. Question number two. There's a thing called a nest thermostat. Fascinating concept that when you walk into the room, eventually the system learns your habits and ways, and therefore things go on and off, whether it's the heating or the air conditioning, based on your actions, and it learns it. And then when you walk in, it will turn on the heating, and then when you walk out, it'll turn it off. Is that okay? That too, I didn't really understand why that should be okay. I'd love to understand why it's okay. And someone told me he has a system, he turns it off before Shabbos. But someone asked me, maybe this is okay. Why? Because this is not considered direct cause. Yet, there's a benefit, and like we said, if something is being done, even if it's by a groma, but it's enu miskaven, you're not having intention, but it's a psikresha, the nichele, which means it's going to happen inevitably, and you enjoy it, it should be a problem. Third question that someone asked me, which is very common today, you walk into a hotel, and when you walk into the hotel, the lights go on. So the system is based on a sensor. So the easiest thing is, which a big poisek told me in America, he said that before Shabbos, you see that they have such a system, you put like a scotch tape or something and you avoid it. The question is that it is okay. What happens if you're stuck and you walked into the hotel, you didn't realize it? So I saw some of the poiskim want to say is that you're walking backwards. So since it's a grama and it's indirect and you're walking in backwards, which is a shinui, it should be okay. The shaila is, these interesting shailas I'm interested in hearing, if anyone knows, the actual mitzias, the reality of how it works. And number two, halachically, if anyone taka has spoken to the Rav or Poisek who has seen in the Sefer that it's okay, I'm excited to learn more. And of course, all these discussions are talking about Shabbos. The idea of Shmirah Shabbos, we just finished off with Yetzias Mitzrayim. And in Yetzias Mitzrayim, wherever we mention Yetzias Mitzrayim is mentioned by Shabbos. Why do we mention Yetzias Mitzrayim on Shabbos? And the answer is, as the Chinuch explains, because the whole concept of Yetzias Mitzrayim was to realize that there's a Boira Olam, that there's a creator of the universe, and not only created the world in 6 days and rested on the seventh, he created the world, but he also is continuously being Mashgiach. Says the Yerushalmi, a pasuk, Birkas Hashem Hita Ashir, the Yerushalmi Maseches Bracha says, Zeu Shabbos. The idea of not doing melacha, why are we so busy? Yes, the shaylos are fascinating, but the concept we should never forget. What's the ikar concept of Shmir Shabbos is that we're able to look and say, Ribbono shel Olam, I'm shoves, I'm holding back from melacha because I recognize and I want to remind myself that at the end of the day, anything that I'm going to have bracha in this week is coming from the fact that I recognize it's from you. Have an amazing day, and any insight is welcome. Tatzlach Rabbah.